I had this idea. What if I could build an entire e-commerce website with all the pages, products, a full checkout flow, a logo, branding, content, sitemap, wireframe, all of it in like 30 minutes or something stupid. And then I thought, I'm gonna do that.
Okay, so the first thing that we need is a brand idea, a brand concept, and kind of some messaging and some core content based around that. So I'm gonna use ChatGPT, the latest version, to help me come up with a concept. And I was thinking like luthier. I've got guitars here. You could probably see them in the back. And at one point early in my life, I wondered if I wanted to be a luthier. That's like someone who builds guitars. I realized that probably there's no money in that. So I chose web design, but there's still this part of me that thinks, whoa, that would be really cool. So anyway, I'm gonna live up my luthier dreams by building a brand around this luthier idea, this guitar maker, handcrafted guitar maker thing. So that's gonna be the idea. I'm gonna fill that into ChatGPT and see if that's going to give us, you know, our core messaging, core idea, brand concept, and we'll start with that. So I wanna build an e-commerce site quickly using Wix Studio. It's a high-end luthier selling handcrafted guitars, shop, custom builds, and repair services. I want the site to look premium with e-commerce capabilities. Give me a brand concept for this project. And let's see what ChatGPT gives us. And no surprise, the results are awesome. So we've got a brand name, a description, a tone of voice, a general style and design direction, even a logo concept, and then the purpose of the site with some key features. This is excellent. So what I'm gonna do here is take and repurpose some of this information to then start building our sitemap and wireframe really quickly. Okay, so now what I wanna do is come up with a sitemap and wireframe. Now, Wix Studio, that's the advanced platform for web agencies and freelancers, has this new tool that's actually incredible. And it's a visual sitemap and wireframe generator. Basically, you add the brief, the creative brief, you fill in a few things, and we've got that data now from ChatGPT. And I'm gonna add that in. It's going to give me basically an entire sitemap with all the pages and content and structure and wireframes that I can work from. So this is gonna save us hours and hours and hours. I'm talking full days worth of work. It's gonna happen right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and use the information that I got from ChatGPT about my brand concept for the high-end luthier e-commerce site. And I'm gonna add that information to these input fields and then see what it will come up with. Okay, so I've got the site structure information filled out. I've renamed it to Tonewood Atelier. I just think that sounds way cooler. I've got all the information filled out. I'm gonna try this, hit continue, and to generate a visual sitemap and wireframes. Let's start generating. And it's currently generating the sitemap and wireframes right here before our very eyes. You could even see it installing some of the apps like the Wix stores and the members area, even a sign up and login, all the main pages. And so now the visual sitemap and wireframes are ready. I can edit the wireframes and the sitemap. So let's see what we have here so far. We've got a nice wireframe page, crafting exquisite guitars, some placeholders for images, client testimonials, and they're even testimonials that are specific to the brand. Obviously, if this was a real business, we wouldn't use fake testimonials, but it's really cool to see this concept being fleshed out right here, all using AI. This is great. I can already see just needing to add some imagery. It's also added more pages. Let's check out the sitemap. So we have a full sitemap with all of the main pages from home, about, experiences, all the way through to contact us, shipping, refunds, and more. And then we have store pages like the cart page, thank you page, product pages, even a side cart, a members area, and a sign up and login that come with the members area. So it's also installed the business apps that we need to run this site. And I can reorder all of this too if I really need to, if I want to move customer testimonials down, or if on the About Us page, I want to have craftsmanship to be higher than meet the team. I can even duplicate or remove or rename sections right here. And then if I liked a certain area, I can just click this and edit right on the canvas. It'll open it up on that page in that section that I want to edit. And I can do that right here. So I've got basically the full wireframed site mapped out. And that only took about a minute or two. So now what I'm going to do is start to make this look better. I'm gonna go and start to adjust my colors and typography and add some imagery. I'm gonna use AI to update the imagery as well. And then we'll move on to adding products and see what we're looking like after that. Okay, so the next logical step is logo and a brand. So I need like a nice looking logo and some colors. And I actually, when I was playing around in Studio there, I saw that there was an option to do a logo generator. I didn't know that was an option in Wix Studio. I don't know if it's gonna be like gimmicky or legit, but we don't have a lot of time and we need a logo and a brand to run with. So let's jump in and let's see what happens.
So I'm going to do a guitar manufacturer, and I want the vibe to be timeless and formal, because I'm thinking guitar manufacturing, this is the timeless craft. The text I want in the logo is going to be Tonewood Atelier. And I'm going to say our craft, your music as the tagline. And we're generating some logos. All right. And here are the options generated so far. I mean, I kind of like this one. That's kind of cool. And I'm going to change the tagline to be handcrafted in Canada, established, let's say 2025. Brand new. And let's see some icon options here. All right, I found our brand. It's going to be this one right here. Oh, this looks incredible. All right, now I can even change the color palettes and create additional designs. I mean, that's kind of neat. Giving me brand concepts. Wow. Let's just adjust this a little bit so it may be a little bit easier to see. That looks great. And I'm going to say this is done. All right, so I got my logo and I've also got my colors right here that I can use in the actual site style. So let's head back to the site and add that logo and the colors right here in the site. Good. Okay, so we've got the logo, branding, framework, messaging, some ideas for all of that. Now we need to do is build the site. We've got the wireframes in place. So we just need to kind of like replace some colors and typography, add some imagery. And I think, you know, it's going to be a little bit on the thin side. Like, I'm not going to go real hardcore into the site design, but I wanted to see how much we can get done quickly. So let's clean up the homepage a bit, clean up the styles, and see how we can make this start to look more like a real professional luthier e-com site. Let's go. Okay, now that I got my colors and my logo, I'm going to add that to the site. So under site styles, I'm actually going to update my color palette so that it matches the brand and the logo. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right now. All right, so I've added some imagery and some text, a little bit of the logo and the colors here. Let's take a quick look at the site so far. This is just the homepage, something pretty simple, but still pretty nice. We've got some imagery, some nice typography and text, crafting exquisite guitars, Tonewood, crafted with passion. So these are going to be the products. So we're going to be showing images of the actual products. I'm going to add that in just a moment here. Got client testimonials, presumably from this rock star right here. And then we've got Explorer Creations. You can view different limited edition, or artisan collection, custom designs, so on. Bespoke creations, just giving a really good vibe of how high quality and handcrafted these guitars are.
All right, last step is to add products to our e-commerce shop. So this is a luthier guitar maker. So this is going to be like custom guitars and standardized guitar and maybe some repair services. So we need to add that to our e-commerce shop, turn it all on, add some prices and some descriptions, and let's see how it looks, see how quickly we can do this. Let's jump in.
Okay, now I'm gonna head back to ChatGPT, and I just need a couple products and services, maybe some names and descriptions that I can add for this e-commerce site. So I'm gonna say I need three products, a templated offering like a one-size-fits-all acoustic signature classic, a custom option for bespoke work, a service for guitar repair, and then I need names, prices, and descriptions for each. Let's let ChatGPT do most of the heavy lifting here so that I can get these products added to my Wix Studio site. So we got the signature acoustic offering, the resonant standard, price $3,500, description. This is great. The bespoke option is the artisan build, starting at $7,500, and then a nice description, and then a repair service, the luthier's touch repair, $150 to $500, depending on the service type. Excellent. So I'm going to take these and head over to Wix Studio now and to start adding these products. So let's head to the category page and see what was set up for us using the built-in wireframe generator. So we've got a nice layout here with a lot of different products. Now, I don't need this many products. This is going to be a very simplified e-commerce store with just two products and a service. So we're going to start here by selecting, we're going to manage the products. And that's going to open up a widget or dashboard here where we can edit the products and the products that were added as like templates and starting points. I'm going to go ahead and delete all of those and re-add our products manually. So let's add our first product. It's going to be a physical product. And this is where I'm going to start filling in this information here that I got from ChatGPT. So let's start with our resonant standard, the signature acoustic guitar. And then we'll add that description. I can also use AI to generate the text for me. Instead of using ChatGPT, it's actually built right in to the product itself, into Wix Studio. So let me just show you how that works. So instead of using ChatGPT and paying for that, we could just use this. Let's see what it provides for us using the AI text creator. Perfect. I actually don't mind that. We got enthusiastic, we got professional and informative. I actually kind of want to do the professional. So we're going to use that text and we're going to add that to our description. Perfect. Now we need to also add additional information like the price. And this one was $3,500. And if I wanted, I can add the cost of goods, profit, and the margin. So let's say the cost of goods on this is roughly, I don't know, let's ask ChatGPT. I've never really had to build a guitar before. I mean, this is fantastic. It's given me some cost breakdown here of the different type of woods, hardware components, and then obviously the labor and time. This is a lot of work personally, right down to the finishing and detailing, overhead costs, any sort of rent and utilities and whatnot, packaging, shipping, overhead. So we're looking at the low range is 1650. Let's say that our low range is 1650 to produce this guitar because it's very productized. So we're going to say 1650, and then it tells us our profit and the margin. That is very neat. We can add custom text fields if we want, product variations like the size, color, or material. Maybe we can say fretboard. We're going to say rosewood, maple, and maybe color. And we can just kind of give like a general color. And then we're going to add that and manage pricing and inventory for each product variant. So maybe we can even like update and say, if you choose to upgrade to like rosewood, it's an extra 350. Upgrade to maple, it's going to be zero because that's going to be the default option. And then we'll apply. So let's say that that's the first product. We're going to add some images. We're just going to find some images here of an acoustic guitar. Let's do this and this, this. Ooh, I like these ones. They kind of look kind of more standardized. Let's just do that. Perfect. Okay. And then that's going to be our first product. We can even edit the SEO settings right here. We can use the SEO assistant and use a little bit of AI to generate alt text for the images if we wanted, and even write a meta description. So we could add those in, but I'm gonna save. And so we have our signature acoustic guitar. Now, if I go to the site, let's see where it shows up here on the product page. There's our signature acoustic guitar. It's popular. If I click it, it's gonna open up the product page. That is so nice. And then you could change the fretboard if you want rosewood or maple. Quantity, obviously you're only gonna get one here. You can add it to the cart, excellent. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the other products. This one's going to be called the artisan build. We'll add a description and we'll just say custom for the ribbon. And this price is going to be $7,500. Cost of goods for this one varies, but let's say the cost is going to be a little bit more because it's custom, roughly $2,500, maybe $3,200 even. And then we can add product options and variations. So if we want it to be fretboard, we could do the same. We could do maple and rosewood. Maybe we can add another option and say tonewood. And we can say, I don't know, what are some options for tonewood here? Let's go. We got mahogany, we got rosewood and walnut. Let's say those are our options. We got mahogany, rosewood, and was it maple or walnut? We're going to add, and then we can even manage pricing for each product variant. So if you wanted to upgrade, you can add that, those product variations. We'll leave that for now though. And we say, let customers buy this product even when it's out of stock, which is a good idea. So if it's out of stock, you can pre-order, and the pre-order limit will be, you could say no limit or one limit, depending on your, how many you have in stock. Well, actually let's add some images and let's find like another guitar here. Let's do this one, there we go. Just a few options, change the cover. We're gonna save that. And then now we have that product in our store as well. All right, so we've got the artisan build, signature acoustic, awesome. It's looking great. This is awesome. So I could choose the fretboard that I want for my custom build, the tone wood, and I can add more options. Obviously for a custom artisan build, I'd want more options and maybe even a message here to leave a note of any custom requests, and then add to cart. Maybe instead of like buying it outright, you do a deposit. So, you know, in the product itself, you could change to add a deposit, or maybe it's like, instead of buying it outright, it's a request to purchase this, and then you'd send them an invoice. But for the sake of this site, we're going to leave it as an actual build. So we got a couple products there. We check it out here and we go to our homepage. We've got a nice, simple, but exquisite page. And then we've got crafted with passion. We could see the couple different options here. The artisan build. This is neat. Let's say that I want, for the signature acoustic guitar, I want actually a rosewood fretboard, and I'm gonna add that to the cart. I could see it here. I can view my cart, estimate delivery. I could check out, I can enter a promo code, add a note. It's all here. And so the site's pretty much built. All I need to do now is in my dashboard, I'd need to make sure to hook up my e-commerce tools so I could see my catalog with my products. I can add new products here. I can perform more actions like importing a CSV file of more products. I can edit the product right here in my dashboard or invite a team member to help update the product as well. And then I'd need to set up so I can get paid so that I can accept payments. And I'd easily do that here in my collect payment method. And once that's hooked up, which takes about a minute or two, then I could go ahead, head to my site, hit publish, visit my site on the web, and start selling my custom guitars and luthier services right here with custom checkout options. I can add it to a cart, I could view my cart, and I could purchase with all the popular payment methods, calculate taxes and shipping, all of that, and manage it right within my Wix Studio dashboard. Done, published, just like that. I don't know what just happened. 30 minutes, we go from I don't know what I'm doing to a brand concept, logo, colors, sitemap, wireframes, copy, pages, products, images, and then publish. That 10, 12 years ago would have taken weeks as a freelancer. Now, you just watched it. You just watched it and it takes minutes. I mean, 30 minutes to an hour, you can have a really good brand concept and minimum viable product launched on the internet. Now, if you're working with clients and you need to get something up and running quickly to prove a concept or to like seal a deal or if you get a client with a tight budget, then you can really do some damage here with tools like Wix Studio. Highly recommend you check it out. Specifically, if you want to know how to get better at Wix Studio, then you're going to want to know how to do this.